G'day, Brucies and Sheilas.
Welcome.
Take no notice. Welcome to Beer Goggles Reviews. Here in sunny England. It's pouring down outside, as it always is, you know. Right, get on with it, Till. Come on. We've got an Australian beer, an Aussie beer. Now, think what you was doing 5 years ago, because it's a vintage ale and extra strong vintage ale. And see, 5 years ago, I was celebrating my 18th birthday, more or less. So, you know, I've had a worried life, you know. Right. 2007, five-year-old vintage there. This is Cooper's. And this is Cooper's vintage. Been blah, 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 this, that, and the other. I ain't going to read too much because you always find you sort of trip up and end up on kind of reading your the taste notes that they give you to kind of taste. And you shouldn't really go into a beer, I believe, anyway. Take no notice of me. I'll, you know, do what you like. But I don't think myself, personally, I don't think you should go into a beer with preconceived taste notes, you know, ideas before you kind of even go into the beer. So you don't read it at all. Just get a different beer each. Try a different beer each week. If you go down to supermarkets or whatever, go to the proper beer aisle, have a little look, go leave all the Wells and Youngs and Courage and whatever, because they're rubbish. But go for pick out one or two of the others. Try a couple of each week, just a couple of beers. And start yourself on that little journey. Instead of going into the McLagers, get them by all means, you know, if you're used to them. But give yourself a little treat and sit down each night. If you get yourself seven or something like that, different ones, or just a few even. Sit down with them, really taste them and go, Jesus, what have I been missing here? You know, you owe it to yourself. Anyway, I do digress. I'm going to crack this open with the old BB, and away we go. Let's do it right-handed, because I am ambiguous, but I prefer me right-hand when I'm opening a beer. I don't want to spill everywhere. Lovely. So nicely, and here's the Cooper man, old Coopers. Good day. Sorry. I'm going to keep that push back on the top once I've finished my little amount. Let's pour it into a Stewart glass. Because this is a beautiful glass for kind of tasting and smelling beers in. And if you do drink from a glass like this, fill it up to the widest part. And then when you tip it, you really get a big surface area open up all of a sudden. And you've got a small aperture on the top to just about fit your bugle in there. Because I've got a big bugle. Right, look at that. Been punched around all my life, that is. Right, looking slightly cloudy. We are, I think, talking bottle conditioned with this. And I may have kind of moved it about a bit. So, forgive me for that, if I have. But it is very viscous as well. So don't worry. But let's get this. Cool, look at that. Straight through the bowl there, look. That's hefty. Look at that. Quite thick. Looking beautiful. Not very kind of lively carbonation, but enough to just kind of have a little small head there. Wished I had a small head. That's beautiful. Yeah, really lovely. You find that, why am I talking? No, I ain't talking to you, am I? You find that you get, when you get some of them more viscous beers, you know, the thicker sort of mouthfeel, that those the kind of the bubbles are really, really microscopic, and you just see them when you hold it up to the light, just see them almost held in suspension, just making their way gradually up the drink. That's really a beautiful sight. Right. Bottoms up. Cheers, chin chin. Let's have a little sniff first. What am I drinking it for? Drinking so little beer nowadays that I'm kind of forgetting how to do it. Right. nice little bitter notes. You've got kind of bitter grapefruit, bit a little bit of a bitter lemon in there. But sweeter notes in there as well. Kind of burnt sweetness. Like when you're kind of caramelising the sugar for whatever reason. If you get a brown sugar and pour it into the thing, let it caramelise a little bit. Sometimes you get these burnt edge notes. Kind of like a burnt sugar smell almost. Little bit of toasted marmalade. Thick cut marmalade. You've got the peel and pith in there as well. Right, let's dive in. Cheers. Oh, and what's it? Good day. Stop here. I'm sorry. Oh, that's sugary. They add sugar to that, do they? It tastes like kind of like some of the Belgian beers when they add a bit of sugar, a bit of invert, what have you. And kind of bump it. It doesn't say sugar, in it. But it tastes really sweet. Really sugary. Right, past those sugary notes. Good lord, it is sugary. You got big sugary notes. It's not really sweet, but it's kind of big sugary notes, if that makes any sense. You've got burnt sugar, you've got normal sugar, you've got kind of big fruity burnt orange taste in there as well. There's a malty character, kind of like the malty shreddies, them little crossy things. I don't know if you get them in other countries, but little crossy square things, little cereals that you get for breakfast. Malty shreddies. You kind of got that in there. It's not bad. You can actually taste brewer's yeast in there as well with this, but not in a nasty way. It's like them little tablets you get. It's kind of like that in there. Bready notes as well. Probably coming up from the yeast. It tastes like they're using like different yeast in there as well. What's the ABV of this? 7.5 ABV. In a 375 milliliter bottle. That's a strange old number. That's half of a 750. Strange. A bit more. There's something slightly thin, slightly missing in it. I'm not sure what it is. It's nice, really nice, but it's something. For something that's vintage, is something just a little bit wafery, a little bit, and it's got a nice viscous mouthfeel, but it's something that's not quite present in there, not quite doing it, you know. Nice bitterness, nice dirty bitterness, that kind of in the background, not a fruity sort of bitterness. There is that as well, but it's a little bit more, one of those kind of. Dirty little things. Pardon me. There's a grapey note in there. Especially on the burp. And that's when you do sometimes pick some of the aroma notes up. When you burp them up, would you believe? Because they warm up in your stomach and move around and whoop, up they come, you know. It's very nice. It's very nice, but I don't know if I'd scream about it. I'd certainly say buy it, try it, and like it. Buy it, try it, and like it without a doubt. That said, there's a lot of other beers out there that are kind of in that range or better, you know, and come in bigger bottles, you know. So. kind of give it a try down the line a little bit. Get your golden prides and all that first, and, you know, try different beers out first. And then have that down the line a little way. But it is a beautiful beer. It is really nice. It's just something missing there, and I can't place my finger on it. It's something watery in something. And watery is the wrong word, because it's just something that's... It's not the hops. The hops are giving a big presence. The malts, maybe it's the malts, because it tastes sugary, but the malts ain't giving that them caramel characteristics as much. There is a caramel there, and a burnt sort of toffee apple candy, but it's kind of just seems to be missing something toffee-fied, you know, that sort of, that lovely malty, chocolatey, coffee sort of aromas and tastes and things, you know. Seems to be missing something along there to balance up on it. But it is a lovely beer. Certainly try it, buy it and like it. Yeah, you let me know what you think. Let me know. Subscribe. Watch the next videos down here and all that business. And Facebook. Chat to me anytime you like. I may be doing a few Google Plus things soon as well. I might even be going down, well, I'll chat about this another time. But, yeah, I'm going to be doing a few different things, hopefully, on the Google Plus. So you may be able to join in with that, or at least kind of credit, comment live and that, you know. So you let me know what you think when I come around to doing them. But until then, I'll see you next time. Look after yourselves. Take care. Bottoms up. Cheers.